Well, I got some ideas. Nothing concrete.
Well, if it goes beyond the idea stage, you tell me that, wouldn't you, Scott?
I like Lauren. I don't seriously want to pin the crime on her. I wouldn't mind pinning the crime on Blake.
Where are we going?
I'm taking you home. This is getting way too dangerous.
No way. We're partners. Remember, we had a deal.
This isn't a game, Lauren. Manfred was murdered because he knew the identity of the killer. He was 10 feet away, for Christ's sake. No. I can't take a chance on the killer getting that close to me.
Lauren should have taken his books.
I know what I need to do.
The police wouldn't have noticed they were missing.
You're not going to stop me. Protect?
Crap, I have no choice. I guess I'm doing this to protect him.
This is the part where he's going to rush out of the car in the rain and reassure Lauren and
it's
allow
all
her to come back with him.
Never let her come with you.
I've seen this scene before in a few different movies.
She'd do anything to find the guy who killed her son.
All right, let's get it over with. This is the Oscar scene coming up. When this game is nominated for an Academy Award, they're going to play like a 30-second clip from this on the Oscar night. Ooh, Scott. Giving your coat to the ladies. It's a perfect fit for her, too. Look how well that coat fits Lauren. Lauren is an amazing tailor, I'll give her that. She has an amazing apartment and an amazing tailor. Not as amazing as Madison's apartment, though. Wow. The pace of this game is really picking up. We're getting a lot of short scenes. In the beginning of the game, we were getting a lot of long scenes. Now we're, like, cutting back and forth between the perspective of the different characters very rapidly. I've got my gun. I'm going to possibly kill someone. Can I just turn and leave right now? Because honestly, it doesn't matter at this point. I've already failed two trials, and I'm already under suspicion by the police. The worst thing I could possibly do right now is kill someone.
Yeah, what are you? Oh, fuck. I said 1,000 times that I don't want any junkies in my door. If you want to score, man, you gotta fucking call first. Come on.
I had a chance to, like, palm him in the nose or something, but I messed up the sequence. Now I'm gonna have to kick his door down or something.
Are you deaf or what? I said get out of here! You're gonna cross me. Hey. Take it easy, man. Huh? Keep cool. What do you want? Go? Money? Tommy?
me what you need. I'm sure we can make a deal.
I don't really want to kill this guy.
Fuck,
now I have to kill him. Run! I'm trying to focus because I don't want Ethan to die. My god, square. Up. Up. Close the door. R1. I missed. Around the corner. Triangle. Down. Right. Alright, wait for him to come around. It was a slow one, so I thought I would wait for him to be in sight, but I don't think I can hit him. I've done this whole sequence right. Is he out of ammo?
Hold it, man. I can do whatever you want.
Got I have to kill him now.
Cash?
Too many shots were fired.
Please.
What's one more?
Please don't kill me, man. I got children.
He does have children. They'd probably be better off without him.
And the little one? That's him. Please, man. I want to see them again. Please. Please don't shoot.
I'm a father too. But I have no choice.
Well, I had no trouble passing that trial. They kind of forced my hand by having him pull out a shotgun on me. I was hoping that Ethan would just, like, threaten him and then, he would just stay cool, and then I would allow Ethan to change his mind and walk out. Maybe after, giving him a warning about, dealing drugs or something. Not all drug dealers in real life are violent like that. It's kind of, in the gun grip. That's where my card is. It's kind of a stereotype that's not entirely true. Whoever made this has been watching too much Quentin Tarantino. Look at that, Sean is almost up to his head. He's not even shouting help anymore, he's just like tilting his neck back. R blank 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 E blank E blank T. That's Roosevelt. Blank 52 Roosevelt something. There can't be very many addresses that match that pattern. But yeah, Sean is a... It's so sad, like he's tilting his neck back to keep his mouth above water, and his eyes are just glazed over, and he's like fighting for dear life, but he looks like he's just about given up. And now this guy is lying dead on the floor in his little girl's room with a cabinet full of stuffed animals and a photo left on the floor, and Ethan didn't even bother cleaning up his fingerprints. He touched everything. He knocked over furniture. At this point, he really just doesn't want to live. He just wants to save Sean and then wants to, like, go to jail for the rest of his life or something. Or maybe commit suicide. Things are looking really bleak for our friend Ethan. I assume Madison is going to meet him once more back at the motel. And I earned a trophy called I'm a Killer.
Mad, it's Sam. I got your information. And the owner of the apartment in Marble Street is a Dr. Adrian Baker. He's a struck-out surgeon. They used to sell drugs to junkies on the quad. He mentioned cash and blasts of cheap-ass apartments, including the one in Marble Street. Of course, he got caught. He did a few months in prison and struck out the medical register.
Interesting. Thanks for the information, Sam. I owe you one.
Hey, Matt. Be careful, okay?
I'm on it. Talk to you later.
So So now Madison is conducting her own investigation, which involves an apartment that was owned and was used as a...
The owner of the apartment where Ethan was supposed to cut his finger lives here.
Yeah, this is the apartment where Ethan was supposed to cut his finger, the one that looked all burned out from a fire. So, Madison is investigating on her own, trying to save Ethan, because we're running out of time. And, the owner of the apartment was a doctor, so he might have, leased it to the killer, or at least, met with the killer.
Hi. I was told that you could get the Tropin. Would that a prescription?
Sorry, we're misinformed. Goodbye.
Hold on. I really need your help here.
She's pretending to be a junkie.
I can pay.
Well, why didn't you say so? Seems to be.
This doctor got fired for doing something bad, and now he's, dealing drugs out of his house.
So, you're looking for bitropin, my dear?
Bitropin,
my dear?
You're
having trouble sleeping? How much do you need?
I don't know, about 3 or 4 boxes.
Well, now, that shouldn't be a problem. Would you like a drink? I was just about to have one.
Sure.
Sure, why not?
I haven't seen you around here before. Who told you about me?
Invent someone.
I met a guy at a party. He popped some bitropin. Told me he got it from you.
I don't know what bitropin is. Is that a fictitious drug? Clients?
Do you have many clients?
A few. I have to ease their anxiety. And my hands been off, thin enough, hard working enough. I reassure those who find the system too difficult. I'm like a safety valve to keep society from imploding.
I'm also very conceited, and I like to torture little kittens.
I heard you had some apartments for rent. I'm looking.
Sorry, darling. Those are all booked up.
Shame. I was looking for something around Marble Street.
I wouldn't come right out with that right away, but that was the only choice. Maybe saying nothing is an option. It's very suspicious that, he doesn't know her, and she's asking about an apartment that was used as part of... I'm not gonna drink.
I'm not really thirsty.
I'll get your prescription. Won't be a moment. Wait here.
Yeah, she's asking right away about an apartment that was used as part of a crime.
Oops. I better take a look around to see if I can find anything before he gets back.
She's gonna look for clues on her own. This is so not a good idea.
Seems to be interested in property, amongst other things.
Property? Are those real estate brochures or something?
Maybe a quick look behind those doors. Or make up some lies if he finds me.
That's a good idea. Just say you're looking for the bathroom. Medical book? Hall House Niar? That's nothing.
You seem to be upset that I wouldn't drink. I get the feeling I did the right thing.
Was he trying to, roofie her?
It's like he retired a bunch of medical supplies on his way out. There's enough sleeping pills here to knock out an army. Mm-hmm.
to open that door very quietly, see what's in the bathroom. He's probably going to come back and I'm not going to be there. I'll just say I went to the bathroom. I don't see anything in the bathroom. There's a prompt to get back out. Oh no, there's a medicine cabinet. PMP. That's nothing. I don't think there's anything in here. I think I have to go through the other door. This is his bedroom. Nothing in his dresser. There's something here. Kako Coco. It was a business card for the Blue Lagoon. That doesn't seem like much of a clue. That's the only thing I can pick up. How about over here?
Stop performing operations. Must be some kind of a weird nostalgia for the past.
He's got kind of a creepy house. Is that the way he went? I don't know if I want to follow him down that hallway. All right, you only live once. Let's follow him down the hallway. Oh! Fuck!
Little ferret. We're gonna have some fun together, my darling. I promise.
Oh my god. That gave me such a jump. Is that a dead body?
Say hello to Matthew. He claimed he had come to the census. Another one of those goddamn government spies.
He probably did come for the census, you psycho.
So, you are interested in my Marble Street apartment.
I'm just gonna keep screaming.
I read it to my friend Paco, if you must know.
Paco?
I have no idea what he does there. Maybe that's a reporting case for the census.
I've got a lot of good clues now if I can escape. A guy named Paco with the Blue Lagoon is involved in this crime. Trying to shake out of these ropes while his back is turned. Yeah, of course, he's gonna operate on me in his basement because he's a psycho.
So I use whatever comes to hand. I hope you won't hold that against me.
I can't even scream loud anymore. I keep jamming scream and nothing is happening.
Just not still.
Shit. Oh, I can look. I can look in different directions. Don't drill me. Fuck. Screaming isn't helping.
As soon as you start to do a little housework, someone always comes.
There's someone at the door, now is my chance to escape. It was a deus ex machina if I've ever seen one. I did it, I shook my foot out. Now I have to slowly drag this thing to my other foot. What is that thing? Oh, it's the drill. Now I'm gonna drill my way out of the ropes. My other foot's tied too tightly to shake out, so I have to drill the rope. Contribution of only $5. Is he a Jehovah's Witness? Yes. I've got the drill next to my hand. This is tense. You've got your hands free. Oh my god, I'm free. Grab the hammer. Fuck! I missed. I missed again. Circle. Trying to see Paco at the Blue Lagoon. I can't die here. Russell! Oh, that was a tough one. Come on, get up, get up, get up, get up. Yes, I grabbed something. Kick him in the balls, good. Now knock him out! Finish him! Get out! R1. Oh my god, don't let him catch that. Don't let him grab that. Fuck, I'm escaping. I'm free. I just need to go up the stairs, that's it. Up the stairs and everything is good. Oh no, I missed one. Yes. Got him. Yes. I got him right in the eyes. I'm gonna be free. Clobber him. Oh no, I missed. Square. Fuck. Was I too slow? I don't like the look of this. Yes! Drill him! I thought I was dead. My heart is pounding right now. That was a scary scene.